Pagkakapon, Pilipinas at buong mundo, Naitay Kapuso. Pahiram po ng 20 minutes ng inyong hapon. Ako po si Boy, and welcome to Fast Talk with Boy Abundar. Sa lahat ng nanonood po sa ating live streaming channel sa YouTube at Facebook, maraming salamat. Sa lahat ng nakikinig po sa Dizzy Double B, welcome to the program. Happy Mother's Day! At ang bisita ho natin ngayong hapon ay isang napakagandang ina, isang kaibigan, and one of the best people in the world, one of my favorites. Naitay Kapuso, please welcome the one and the only, Dina Bonavie.
Hi! Glad to be back.
You are always welcome here on Fast Talk.
Milagro, you didn't call me Miss Bo.
No, I'm gonna call you Miss
like
Bo
you always do.
In a while. Maraming maraming salamat.
Thank you.
Kumusta?
Eto,
very
super busy.
Well,
I'm happy naman. I'm not complaining.
We cannot.
I'm super busy and I'm happily busy.
We're celebrating Mother's Day and kami natutuwa talaga na ikaw ang ating naging bisita. Totoo yun.
Talaga?
Yes.
Sabi ko, sobrang daldal.
Hindi. This is your show. Dina, take me back to when you were 19. You became a mother.
Long time.
You became a young mother at 19. How was that? Kumusta
yun? Not yet. Nanganak ako 20.
20 ka na.
But well, you're a mother na rin when you're pregnant at 19. Oh, it was hard. Parang it came unexpectedly. Parang I didn't expect to be a mother at that time. My career was like, woo, it was going up. And then suddenly, poof, something happened. So, young as I was really confused. Parang I didn't know, what am I gonna do? Am I really in love? Is this love or what? What am I going to do? Am I just doing this to please some people who are afraid na masira yung reputation or what? My dad, for example, parang he was so scared na masisira yung family name, you know, it's a disgrace. People will say ganito, ganyan, ganyan, ganyan. My mom naman is parang, okay, have it adopted, ganyan, ganyan. But I'm like, what am I gonna do? I mean, the only thing I really was sure of was I didn't want my child to experience what I went through. Growing up na separated yung parents.
Okay, so you got married, and that was the story. And you had Danica, mm-hmm. Pagkatapos si Oyo.
2 years later, I had Oyo.
Right. Paano ka magdisiplina sa mga anak? Nakikipagkwentuhan ka, nagbabasa ka ng mga stories.
Very much of a disciplinarian. Like early on, I never baby talked Danica. And early on, talagang I would impose na bawal ang sinungaling. But kasi before si Danica, naalala ko, naku, napalo ko yan eh. Kasi may kagat si Oyo. Sabi ko, why does Oyo have a bite? Who bit him? Sabi kong ganun. Sabi ni Danica, not me, mama. Who bit your brother? Is it Mitch? Eh, yung pamangkin ko, halos magkaedad sila. Mm. It's Mitch. Sabi ko, how can Mitch do it? Eh, sabi ko, Mitch doesn't have teeth. Sabi ko, you better tell the truth or I'm going to spank you real hard. Mama, I didn't bite Oya boy. Tapos sabi ko, you tell the truth, otherwise you're going to kneel in mung beans. I'm telling you. Finally sabi niya, Mama, I know na who bite Oya boy. Who bit? Bit. Kasi I am so particular about grammar. So bata pa lang, anong bite? Bit. Past tense. I know now who bit Oyo. Who? The devil. The devil daw.
Okay.
Sabi ko lang, yak. Pinaluhod ko nga sa bigas. Mm. E di syempre, kinagalitan ako ni Vic. Batang-bata yan, pinapatulan mo, pinapaluhod mo sa bigas. Bakit? I mean, we actually parent according to the way we were parented. Don't you?
Yeah, I totally agree.
You parent according to the way you were parented. Normally, you raise your kids according to the way you were raised. But in my case, maybe in the beginning it was like that because that was how my father raised me. But I didn't do what my mom did.
Which was?
Kasi my mom, she's European, diba? She's Swiss. So, very independent. She will never put on your socks. She will never go to your graduation. Independent eh. Wala silang mga ganun-ganun.
No, what you were trying to say is, you were mothering dahil yun ang alam mo. Yun ang magpapalaki sa'yo. Spoilers, Rick.
Nako and how, siya and the lola. Too much spoiler. Kaya sabi ko, walang mangyayari kung ganito. So sabi ko kay Vic, dapat hindi tayo magkahiwalay ng desisyon. Mm-mm. Kung anong desisyon ko, ito yung desisyon. dapat mag-usap tayo na iisa lang ang desisyon. If you have a different decision than mine, then this is going to be a problem. But you must remember, we were talking about this, hiwalay na kami. Oh. I was separated at the age of 23. I built my own house at the age of 23.
But you were
Danny
together
was only four.
For about, what, 5, 6 years?
6 years.
6 years, okay. Ah, so okay.
So, di ba? Iba yung rules sa Ayala Heights, iba yung rules sa Valle Verde. So, sabi ko yung bata confused kasi ito yung rule dito, ito yung rule dito.
Before we talk about you being a single mother, noong sabi mo nga naghiwalay kayo, you stayed together for 6 years. Naalala ko lang because we're doing this special dito sa GMA7. Umpisa na po ngayong Sunday, May 12, Mother's Day. I'm doing a special called My Mother, My Story. Ang una ho naming guest ay si Luis Manzano. And we are honored with the presence or by the presence of Miss Vilma Santos and Ryan Christian.
Wow.
Isa sa mga kwento, Miss Bo, ay ni Luis. Nung maghihiwalay si Eduardo at saka si Ate V, si V, dinala siya sa libingan ng mga bayani. Panoorin niyo po yung special para malaman niyo po kung ano ang kanilang pinag-usapan.
Libingan ng mga bayani?
Yes.
Bakit
doon,
cementerio?
He was, what, about 4 or 5 years old. Mm. He was brought by his dad and mom sa libingan ng mga bayani at doon sila nag-usap-usap. That's the narrative of how they broke the news to the young Luis na kami naghiwalay na. Noong kayo ni Vic naghiwalay, did you do a conversation with the children?
No, it was the other way around because well, masakit mang isipin at balik-balikan yun, but it was the other way around because the kids started noticing na how come Papa's not coming home? How come Daddy's always not home? Where is he? Ganyan ganyan. And then I don't know. Maybe he's at work, ganyan ganyan hanggang sa muna one day siya hindi uuwi, naging 2 days, naging 3 days. Naging 4 days hanggang sa hindi na siya umuwi. And then parang nasanay na yung mga bata na wala na siya. And then, wala, sinabi lang ni Vic na, okay, weekends you're gonna spend with me and then weekdays you're going to spend with your mama, ganyan-ganyan.
Pero you had that conversation. You had that agreement na, okay, akin ang weekend, sa'yo yung mga bata.
Kami lang ni Vic yun.
Kayo lang dalawa. Sa mga bata, hindi mo na ipinaliwanag kung bakit kayo
naghiwalay. Well, at one time sinabi ko, and I remember we were in the set of one movie we were doing and nagkaiyakan kami na, you know, I wish that we could spend more time with Daddy, but I think, you know, we're going through some challenges. And it's going to take time before I spend time with Daddy again. Pero si Oyo nun, violent reaction, no! I want Daddy! I want Daddy! Only Daddy! No other, only Daddy. Kaya pa kahit na may lumalapit sa akin ko, actor, go away! Go away! Akala niya lagi may kumukuha sa akin.
Oh.
Si Danica was more of, alam niya na, I don't know, baka sinabi ng lola, hindi ko alam. Pero, I never really got to tell her. Pero, siya yung lagi naghahanap sa daddy niya. Because when Danica was alone, wala pa siyang kapatid, yun yung happiest years namin ni Vic eh. Yung every weekend, we would go out. We would go out of town every weekend. Danica was the favorite of everyone. Talagang papasa-pasa. Everybody wanted to carry her. Everybody wanted to hold her, to feed her. And then all of a sudden, iba na.
Okay.
So talagang afektado. So I just said, well, I hope it's not like this. And then that's when she said, na, Mommy, I want you and Daddy to be back together. Every time I remember that, naiiyak ako, boy. Kasi, as a mother, not because, you know, I gusto ko kami pa rin ni Vic kasi si Vic Soto siya, no. But every mother would want to be with the father of her children.
Of course.
It's every mother's wish to have a whole family, not a broken one. So when you remember the pain of your children while they're telling you that, you feel so helpless, eh. You wish you could change things, but you can't.
There was no blame game in front of the children.
No.
Hindi kayo nag-away sa harap ng mga bata.
Never. Kami ni Vic, never. Ah, actually, nagulat nga yung mga bata. How come you're not together anymore? I never heard you and Daddy fight. Kasi we never fight in front of the kids.
Oh.
We never fight in front of the kids, and I never badmouthed their dad to the children. Never.
Kaya napakaganda ng relasyon never ng mga anak mo sa kanilang tatay.
Never ko siya siniraan sa mga anak niya. And I'd always say, you will only have one dad and that's your dad and you have to respect him.
Did you have a confrontation with Vic about, ito yung nakaraan ako kasi eh, napapag-usapan lamang natin because of the dynamics of the relationship. Did you have a conversation with Vic about isang kaibigan natin, Connie Reyes? Mm. Did you have a conversation?
Yeah. But it wasn't even a spirited fight or what. Quiet lang.
Quiet na pag-uusap.
Parang bakit? Bakit?
Tapos did you get an answer?
Yeah. Because I was inexperienced. And sabi ko, what can you do? Virgin ako eh. I mean, what? You want me to read all the books? I mean, you want to play games? Show me how. I was a kid. I didn't know much. Parang yun ang sinabi niya sa aking sagot.
Para lang matapos yung narrative na yun, how did the reconciliation, how did the friendship, how did the forgiveness happen?
Oh, wow. It took a lot of time. Until the point na Danica was telling me, alam mo, Mommy, you're so bitter. I wish you would really let go because you're so bitter. Kasi parang every waking moment, konting, if there's a little opportunity, I would, you know, like when I felt sad and alone and I was having a hard time with the kids, like when we're transferring houses and all these things.
Parang, you would rant.
I would rant. Kasi di ba parang bata-bata ko, I should have a man with me.
Ang ganda-ganda ko.
Parang I'm so pretty. Parang
sikat
why?
Sikat na sikat ako, no? Because,
di ba parang I'm up there and parang what? Are you serious? Di ba? But parang even, I wasn't a child anymore, but 23 is young. Di ba?
Yes.
Parang, you don't understand a lot of things. But, I don't know, I guess you know through time, sabi ko, walang pupuntahan ito unless I really let go and just accept that it's like this. And so eventually, naging Christian ako after studying all the many religions and then I bumped into her and she asked me, do you want to go to our church? Parang nagulat ako, go to your church. Bulugulong. But then, you know, sabi ni Danica, hindi ka naman pumupunta sa church para sa tao eh. Diba? You're going there for God. So, then I realized, tapos sabi, and then nakita ko na, I mean, she changed in leaps and bounds. Like, bringing people to God, bringing people to Jesus, telling people about the good news of salvation. So I asked myself, my God, is this a person I'd like to hate? I can't hate this person. I can't. So I let it go. And I gave her a bunch of white roses and I said, I forgive you. And then she, actually there was one time na she tried to talk to me and ano pa ako nun, kasi it was in public. But then I forgave her. I forgave Vic. I also sent him flowers and I said, I forgive you. But most of all, I forgive me. And then I imagine myself, you know, I went to the beach one time with the kids and I imagine myself throwing all my tears into the sea. All my sama ng loob, draining it out of me. Parang I'm letting you go. I want a fresh start, a new me. I'm still valuable. I'm still able.
I have worth.
I am worth it. You know, I can reinvent myself. All is not lost. I can do things. And that's what happened.
What did you become and what didn't you become because of your children and because of your mother? Ang kasagutan sa pagbabalik po ng Fast Talk with Boy Abuelo. We're back on the show. Kasama po natin si Miss Bo. Bago natin ipagpatuloy ang ating kwentuhan, let's do Fast Talk.
Yeah! Oh my gosh! Magpa-Fast Talk pa ba ako?
Kailangan. 2 minutes to do this and our time begins now. Dina natuto o Dina magpapauto?
Dina magpapauto.
Di magtataray o Dina aaray?
Dina aaray.
Abot kamay, hugas kamay.
Abot kamay.
Manila, Bicol.
Manila.
Ateneo, UP.
Ateneo.
Hot mama, hot lola.
Hot mama and lola.
Underage, tender age.
Underage.
Magdusa ka, tinik sa dibdib.
Magdusa ka.
Kailan ka pinakamaganda?
Pagising ko sa umaga.
Kailan ka pinakamatapang?
Kapag inaape ako.
Kailan ka pinakasexy?
Kapag malamig ang aircon.
Kailan pinakagwapo ang asawa mo?
pag bagong ligo.
Paboritong ginagawa sa iyo ni DV?
Nako, he's very malambing.
Sino ang unang nangangalabit?
Siya, siyempre.
Misinterpreted or misunderstood?
Misinterpreted.
Prangka o mataray?
Prangka.
Mayaman o maganda?
Both. Mahirap pag maganda kung hindi mayaman.
Yummy or sexy?
Both.
Complete the sentence. Bakit ba ganyan?
Bakit ba ganyan? Kahit ang ganda-ganda mo, linoloko ka pa rin ng mga lalaki.
Dinner for three. Sinong iimbitahan mo?
Dinner for three?
Sige nga.
Si Connie, si Vic, ako. Para masara na talaga lahat ng mga loose ends na parang that's a finished chapter and we're okay.
Praise God.
We're a modern family.
Is that lights on or lights off?
Lights on. Sayang naman ang alindog. So hindi makikita.
Happiness or chocolates?
Well, I think at this age, I'd rather have chocolates. But not sugar-free, please.
Best time for chocolates?
After meals. Actually, don't take sweets na eh.
Yeah.
Pero okay lang, pag zero sugar.
Complete the sentence. I am Dina. First and foremost, I am.
I am Dina Bonnevy, first and foremost, a believer and child of God. I'm a Christian. I am a loving wife, a loving mother, and last of all, a slaying, charming, hot actress. Bilib na bilib sa sarili. Joke lang.
May binabagayan. Bagay na bagay sa iyo. Let's talk about finding love. Finding DV. Kumusta yung journey na yun?
Ay nako, alam mo yung sinasabi niya, love comes from the most unexpected places.
Totoo yun.
Totoo yun. I never thought, parang wala na akong gana eh. I didn't want to have a boyfriend. I didn't want to go out. Nothing. So, ayan. I mean, it came at a time I least expected. I was 50. Sabi ko nga, Lord, parang meron nang nakasulat sa noo ko na ano, consume before January 27, 1962. Kasi on that day, 50 na ako, Lord. Kung meron ka ibibigay, ibigay mo. At baka may expiration date na, catch! 50! Sabi ko, kung hindi mo ibibigay, sabihin mo na. Kasi ay, hindi na ako magpapaganda. Wana. Pero kung ibibigay mo, now na. Just dumating.
Let me go to my last question. What have you become because of your children? Or even what haven't you become?
What haven't I become because of my children? I didn't become the leading lady of Mel Gibson in East of Eden. No, it's not a joke.
No, totoo yun.
I was offered to star in East of Eden with Mel Gibson after I did A Dangerous Life by Hal and Val McElroy, and they were working in The Village, Australia. I was offered to live in Australia and to be an actress there and eventually be in Hollywood, HBO.
Wow.
I was offered, di dapat sana ngayon Hollywood actress ako, and I'm slaying it in the Met Gala. Chura ni Tyler. O, oh, diba?
That was an interesting dress in there. I mean, so you didn't become that?
I didn't become that because I chose my kids. Kasi at that time na nagpaalam ako kay Vic, sabi ko, kukunin ko yung mga bata, pupunta kami ng Australia, and I'm gonna live there. Vic said, if you do that, you will never see your kids again. What have I become because of my kids? I became an entrepreneur. I had to look for other ways and means to make money aside from being an actress and a talk show host. So I put up businesses and I became a successful businesswoman because of my inspiration, my kids. I wanted my kids to have a good life.
Right. What have you?
I became a forgiver.
You became
and I
a
stopped,
forgiver.
And I stopped being judgmental. Kasi before I was so judgmental, eh, I was masyado akong feeling era no. Parang feeling ko, ang ganda-ganda ko. Ah. Palagi akong tama. But then, you know, you realize na, hey, you're not always right, you know.
Right.
Marami ka ring mali. So, yeah.
Ms. Bo, maraming salamat.
Thank you, boys.
Thank you
always a
much.
Pleasure to be with you.
Thank you. Salamat, Ms.
Thank
Bo.
You,
salamat.
Boy.
Salamat, salamat.
And of course, you also have my love and respect.
Thank you.
There's only one Boy Abunda.
I love you,
Thank
Ms.
you.
Bonnevy. Maraming salamat po, Naitay Kapuso, sa inyong pagpapatuloy sa amin, sa inyong mga puso at tahanan araw-araw. Be kind. And make your nanay and tatay proud. Hashtag say thank you. Do one good thing a day and let's make a difference. Let's make this world a better place. Goodbye for now and God bless. Happy Mother's Day! Happy Mother's Day!